So far I've kept it simple and done a 1D array. But how do I create or manipulate a 2D array? Or a higher dimension array? That's pretty easy too. Let's go back to my random number generator. Wrap it in a for loop as before, and then wrap it in another for loop. So they're nested. Wire this out to the border of the outer loop, create an indicator, and there we are. We have a 2D array. I need to tell LabVIEW how big to make this, so let's say I put in 4 and 6. Run it, and there we go. 6 rows and 4 columns. So here's my row, here's my column. And you can guess that if I made a copy of this, changed it to a control, and wired it into nested for loops, that auto-indexing would take over, both loops would know how many times to run, and I would go one by one and access scalar elements in this array. Let's take a look. Highlight execution. One by one, we see each individual element being accessed across the top, then the next row, and so on. This wire right here would be the row we're accessing. Of course, the inner wire is the scalar. Well, that was fun. I agree. But did you get confused at all with the indexing, especially the inputs? Well, if you're taking the CLAT exam, it's a common topic. And next time, we'll expand a bit more on auto-indexing inputs and how many times a loop runs and what will be the resulting output. So come on back.